Hi, welcome again to Willey Farms. I'm Donna Cavender. Hey, the weather's getting warmer and that's so exciting. Today's show, we're going to talk about plants. We're going to talk about keeping the bugs away from your plants and also talking about some silk flowers and the arrangements that you can do with containers that you already have right around the house. So I hope that you'll stick around. We hope that you'll stop by and see us sometime. We're on Route 13, Towns End. If you're traveling Route 1, very easy, get off in Smyrna or in Odessa and travel on 13, and here we are. Also, website, willeyfarmsde.com. You can also find us on Twitter, on Instagram, and on Facebook. So I hope that you'll check us out and like us on those. And of course, the warmer weather is here, so that means all kinds of great new choices here in the produce department, and of course, beautiful flowers in the greenhouse. So I hope you'll stop by and check it all out. Enjoy the show. Well, we're here in the greenhouse with Kathy Smith. Hi, Kathy.
Hey, Donna, how are you?
I am fine, and today we're talking about bugs.
Bugs.
We're trying to figure out how to keep some bugs away and how to bring some bugs to us, right? Okay, let's start down here. What do we have? Some of these I can identify. Some of them I can't. So what do we have? What do we start with?
A sniff of this one.
A sniff of this one. I love it when you can just kind of rub the... Okay, this is this lemon.
Lemon balm, yeah.
Lemon balm.
So it has a pretty powerful smell. It is an aggressive plant, so you want to plant something like that in your pot, but you can put that around your patio.
Now, aggressive, you mean it just...
Grows fast.
Grows fast and overtakes. Okay.
Yes. And so you can add some lavender to that. Any of these plants you can plant, like do a few of them together or separately, whatever, but keep those around your deck area.
Okay.
You know, anywhere that you're going to be picnicking, things like that, and they're going to help you deter mosquitoes.
So not only do they smell good, but
they're working plants. Yeah.
Okay.
So we have the mosquito plant here, of course. We all know that citronella. That's an old one.
Okay.
Catnip. I don't know if a lot of people know that it's 10 times more powerful than DEET. So that has been proven. So that's actually a really good one.
But you'll attract all the cats in the neighborhood, though, right?
Yes, you will. If you rub that on your body, they're going to be following you everywhere.
Okay.
So then here we have some pineapple sage, which is really pretty. It has this limey kind of color.
Okay.
Some pretty red flowers.
It does flower.
Yes, it does flower.
Good.
Right here on the tag. So we've got this next to the cabbage, because it is a really good friend to the cabbage, cauliflower, all those little cousins, broccoli.
Okay.
All those. It will just about deter all the bugs that want to be around your cabbage to eat your cabbage up.
Okay.
So it keeps away the cabbage moths, things like that.
And once again, this is pineapple sage?
Pineapple sage. And it also aids in the growth of your cabbage and your tomatoes.
Wow.
And carrots too.
It's
a super plant.
All right.
You don't want to put it near your cucumbers because it would deter, you know, slow down the growth of your cucumbers. They don't get along.
Okay.
And it will also strengthen the flavor of your strawberries. So that's a good one.
All right.
So if you have pets, pennyroyal is a good one. It is also aggressive, but if you can find a way to contain it.
Pennyroyal.
Yeah.
And that's like a ground cover?
It's a ground cover. And smell that.
Oh, yeah.
Very nice fragrance.
And it does what?
Keeps the fleas away. The fleas don't like the smell of it.
Okay.
Yes.
I have cats, so I just might have to get
there
some of those. Okay.
Here we have some spearmint that helps keep.
Ooh.
Another one you want to keep in the pot, but nice one to have around the deck to keep the mosquitoes away.
Okay. And when you want a nice aroma,
take some off and put it in your tea.
Oh, right.
Yeah, keeps the aphids away, too, so that's something good to maybe have near your rose bushes and some of your other flowers.
Okay.
Nobody likes the Japanese beetles, hate the Japanese beetles.
All right, let's get rid of the Japanese beetles.
So right here we have a Senna geranium, some rue, and some garlic.
Oh, so now what do you do with the garlic?
Is very easy to plant. Normally you would plant it in the fall, but you can just break these apart and plant them, and they'll be up. Before winter, and then they'll be ready next year to do their job to help keep
the Japanese beetles
away.
So after you plant that and it comes up, that's what keeps the repels.
I like to have it near my rose bushes because I don't like the Japanese beetles on it. So it helps.
Good to know.
It won't keep them
Japanese
all away, but
beetles,
it does
help. They can be terrible.
Yep.
Okay.
So here I have a tomato plant, and if we put some borage and basil around with that, then that's going to help keep away those nasty old hornworms that get on your tomatoes. And the basil will also help keep away the thrip.
And so when you when you're making marinara sauce, you only have to go to one part of the garden to get your tomatoes and your basil, right?
And the borage gets a beautiful blue flower on it, so it looks really pretty.
Okay.
So, and here we have the lavender, and a lot of insects don't like that either.
Okay.
And
they just don't know what they're missing. Lavender is nice. Mm-hmm.
And I like to take a couple sprigs and put in my bath water.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
Very multi-use plant.
So here we have all the marigolds, which people have been putting those in their garden for years to help keep the some of the bugs away.
I have heard that
if the rabbits away.
If you ring the garden with marigolds, then you keep away the rabbits.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. So so sage and rosemary, and that's right here.
Yeah.
Okay. You can add this to your wood charcoal on your grill.
Oh,
and get the aromas going in the air to keep the mosquitoes
away. And that keeps the mosquitoes away.
It acts like an incense,
Wow.
So there you go. I have petunias here, and they keep away the asparagus beetles. So you can plant that.
Oh, okay.
So they do some
And they're beautiful.
Here. Yeah. Peppermint. Mice do not like peppermint. We do not like mice. So, and here I just have a few, because we want the good bugs.
Right. We've been talking about how you keep different bugs away, but there are some bugs and small insects that we like.
So here we have some hyssop. Bees love it. I know some people don't like bees, but they really won't bother if you don't bother them.
Right.
Calendula. And these are all good for bees and butterflies.
Okay.
Birds. Santavilla here. That's another one here. So, and then also are just regular scented geraniums. They'll help keep away the mosquitoes. So.
Okay.
We have no mosquitoes here because we have all these.
We have all these. That's great. Okay, and so this is all these are the plants that do that job. Yeah. But we also have other things that are also natural and organic.
This is the dietaceous earth, which is a powder. And most animals or insects that get around your vegetables are crawling. So this is organic. You can just put a little ring around it, and no slugs, nothing's going to crawl through that. If they do, they're going to die.
Oh, okay. Yeah. And we have some sprays
as well. Yeah, we have some fungicide, some weed killer, a 3-in-1 that does a little bit of everything.
Always
and
good.
They're all organic, safe to use on your vegetables and all that.
Great. So that's what we're talking about. Everything that's natural, that's organic, and some great options here.
Yeah.
Wonderful options. All right, Kathy, thank you so much. And now we know all about bugs. So we were talking about the renovations that we've been doing all winter here at Willey Farms, and this is another one of our renovations, our beautiful vestibule here going into Wicker. We've got lots of great things for you to check out here. Now, we were talking about good bugs and bad bugs in our last segment, and now we're going to move on to beautiful silk flowers and how to arrange them. So let's go take a look. Well, we've made our way here to the Home Accent and Gifts area, and I'm here with Gretchen. Good morning, Gretchen. Everything okay with you?
Everything's good.
All right. We've got beautiful silk flowers here in the Home Accent area. Just so many of them everywhere, and they're absolutely gorgeous. These are not your grandmother's silk flowers anymore.
These are not.
They look so
stunning.
Real.
Yeah.
And not everybody feels like they have the talent to arrange and do us, but we've got some great ideas on how you can have beautiful silk flowers arranged in your home. So let's get started. We've got a teapot.
The silk flowers we have here are just so nice. One thing that really helps us is because we have a greenhouse, we actually know what they look like, what they're supposed to look like.
Right.
So just the buying part, we're buying the right silks for you.
Okay.
So
and
we've
you
got
could
this
use
super
this
cute,
a teapot or any other kind of
any other little short container.
Okay.
I've got pansies here.
All right.
This has got an adorable little top, and we're actually going to turn it and let it be a piece of statuary.
Okay.
And we
just drop
pop those guys
in. That's it.
Done.
Perfect.
Done.
Beautiful. Nice little centerpiece.
Yes.
Okay. We've got baskets.
Got
so
a
that's
basket.
A nice, and that's what they used to go out into the fields and gather the flowers
That's exactly what it is. It's a gathering basket.
Okay.
And anymore, we've got silks with great looking stems. They're designed so that they look like they're growing
very
the right
natural.
Way. Yes, this is how they would be on your rose bush.
Okay.
Maybe even better. And in this instance, we're just going to pile them in. We're just going to do just like if you were out and you were gathering up your roses in the garden.
Yeah, so it looks like you just came in from the garden and you
and
got
you've,
all these
and
beautiful
And you've set
flowers.
Your basket down. That's exactly right.
Okay.
A couple different colors. You could certainly use all one color, like you got them all off of one really big rose bush.
Right, right.
And we're just ducking them in there. And then,
beautiful.
Again, just to show that you just came out of the garden, you could pop some little
gardening
gloves.
Make it nice. Okay. And your clippers?
I'm just so exhausted from picking all these beautiful roses.
Okay. Well, I see we have a mantle here, and it's got also some beautiful. Now, what kind of flowers are these representing?
These are hydrangeas.
Hydrangeas.
And again, the design of them makes them look great without doing a darn thing to them.
Okay.
Again, nice stems. We're not going to cut anything. Of course, you're going to take off the tags. But we just tuck them in.
Behind. And that's what these have been done.
And these
too.
Are just tucked in, too.
Just
didn't cut them, didn't do a darn thing
to
them.
Okay. Beautiful. Looks nice on a mantle.
Well, and this little extra touch. Again, if you don't have time, you're just kind of lazy. The lazy designer.
Oh, well, okay, let's just say it's the person that is too busy for this sort of thing, so we can help them out with that. Okay, so what's the finishing touch?
The finishing touch is, in here I have a set of battery-operated lights.
Beautiful!
What's really nice about this light set, it can go in and it can go outside too, so you could even use it out on your front porch.
Okay.
The genius is there's a timer. I just turned it on. It's going to stay for 6 hours, and then it's going to turn off for 18 hours, and then tomorrow at this very same time, it's going to turn on again for 6 hours. So I don't have to worry about plugging, unplugging. It's doing all the work. It's battery operated, so no wires hanging out or anything.
And we have those here as well.
We do, and this is not the right time, but if you were going to be doing this at Christmas time,
you could have maybe holly and berries up here instead of
Absolutely.
The hydrangeas.
Absolutely.
Beautiful. Okay.
Wonderful?
Great options, but we have some other options too, don't we?
Oh, lots more.
I see that these are beautiful color, and these are crocus, right?
Crocus, yeah.
Okay. And this beautiful container here that we have, and that makes a beautiful
It does. And this arrangement, when we're talking about doing things fast or doing things the lazy way, this one actually is done the proper way, which is how we do them here at Willey Farms.
Right.
There's a styrofoam in there. There's moss to cover the styrofoam. Mm-hmm. And then it's nicely arranged.
And you use that with real flowers. And so to make these flowers look even more real, you use the same thing. Right?
Well, even just to keep them stable. This
can
go on a porch or something, and it's not going to go anywhere.
Okay.
If you got tired of it, because, say, crocus are not your thing,
this
color could actually go quite into the season. But crocus are a spring flower.
Right.
Say you wanted to change it out, you pull out the crocus and you tuck in,
put in geranium.
Some beautiful geraniums.
And that's really appropriate throughout the summer.
Through the summer, you can get into September with them.
Okay. So we've got some different pots and containers
Say
here.
Say you didn't have to have it so that it was going to be on the porch and be really stable. It's just going to be in your house.
Mm-hmm. No wind or anything
like
that.
Winds are probably going to come through your house.
Okay.
This pot's just empty. No styrofoam in it.
No styrofoam, no nothing.
Done.
Well, look at that.
Done.
That looks great.
And we can probably decorate this table in that same way in about 3 seconds. And then these are bouquets that we get in, already made.
And you're going to put both of them?
I'm going to put both of them in. They're actually, they match, but they're not actually exactly the same.
Okay.
And then we've got
It's beautiful.
A pot. Now,
That's
this container
gorgeous.
Here is solid. Sometimes you don't have a solid container. Like we have.
Oh, I see. You can't see through it.
Yes.
Right. Okay.
And this guy here.
Everybody has a beautiful clear vase this.
Yeah. You got your Valentine's roses in a clear vase probably.
Right.
In this case, what we've done, because these stems aren't the prettiest, this is something that's probably usually just going to go in a pot that you're going to hide, as in those, but what we have is a clear container, so we're going to fake out the clear container, and
so that
we've
they
just
don't
taken
see the
off,
stems.
We've taken off these beautiful leaves, and we've just taken two, and we've tucked
Swirled
them in
them
down
around,
there,
and
that was just gorgeous, but say you didn't want these orchids here. You wanted to go into summer, and this is how they come to you. It doesn't look special and wonderful.
When we unpack them, they look this lovely.
That's as lovely as they look, yes.
When you get a hold of them, and you can...
And you've got something just gorgeous.
So there's a wire in here, and you just kind of bend it?
Yes, and just like you did, you're just going to slowly...
Okay.
And it's just more naturally how it grows.
Awesome.
And you fluff it out.
Awesome, okay.
And then we've also got things that you can just plop on a counter. This guy, this is the newest thing, where you see the roots, you see the root ball. They've got it, sometimes some of them just looks like dirt.
Okay.
This one has a mossy look to it. Mm-hmm. It looks so cute, just like
that. Just like that, or
however, you can
put it in a funky.
You can put it in a really cool container, and it changes the look of it. It looks completely different. It was very elegant before, now it's like elegantly
kind of funky. Now this is like a terrarium, is that right?
This is a little bell jar.
Bell jar.
And same idea with this little plant. He's got the dirt on the bottom, and it just takes him up another level.
And
that's
a silk plant.
Silk plant.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, beautiful. Now, we also have some other things. Now, we've been talking about how to make it really easy for the person who, number one, doesn't think they're talented enough to do anything that looks this beautiful, or number two, doesn't have the time. And that's what I want to say. They're not lazy. They're just too busy.
Yes.
So if you're too busy, but you have something specific, we can help you out with that, too.
Absolutely. We've got containers that we can make for you. They're already ready to go. And again, you let the silks work for you if you've got a container. We've got these little glass chunks.
That make it look prettier with the stems down in the bowl.
And you just put some stems in, and it kicks it up a notch. It doesn't look like you did it yourself. It looks like we did it for you.
Right. And as you know, if you come in and pick out the things that you like, that's great. Take it home and do it yourself. But if you want us to do it, you can also come in and pick out the right colors that you want and tell us how tall it needs to be and all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
All right. And we also have the cutest little fairies and little gnomes.
Little mini gnomes.
That can go into different decorations as well.
Yes.
The fairy gardens are really, really popular now.
They really are.
Okay.
They really are. And you don't actually have to have a fairy garden to put them in. They can just be next to something else.
Yeah, they're so cute.
They are.
Absolutely
they are.
Adorable. Okay, a lot of great ideas. Thank you, Gretchen.
Thank you.
So we showed you how to work with silk flowers, and now we're moving on to the live stuff. And we're here in the brand new garden center area. We've moved the garden center out of where it used to be into the large wooden greenhouse. We still have plenty of great garden supplies for you. We had to make room for more gifts, which is fun too. We've got the rakes and we've got the gloves to keep your hands clean. And look at these are gorgeous little things here. These are fun, all the boots and the garden shoes too. So come by and check them out. But right now, we've got a special guest. Let's go visit with Heather Callahan. Now, we're with the real stuff right now. And with me again is Heather Callahan from Michelle's.
Hi, Donna.
Thank you for coming out again. She was with us about a year ago and brought all of her wonderful plants and her wonderful information on how to plant, where to plant, what to do, and all that sort of thing. So that's what we want to share with you today. And we're talking about cool weather plants. That's where we're going to start. Right.
We're it's cold, it's gray out there, Easter's coming, and there's no reason you can't come home to a beautiful pot on your doorstep.
Yeah,
pick your spirits up.
The weather this past winter has not been horrible, but it's been cold and it's winter.
It's been so all
it's
over
dreary,
the place.
And people are ready for color.
They are.
They're ready for
they
color.
Are.
Okay, so I've rolled up my sleeves and I'm ready to go here.
Okay, so containers, always the first place you start is color and what color you want. You want to coordinate with, usually these are going on a front step or patio. You want to coordinate with your siding and your color scheme.
Sure, and you can, there's all different kinds.
Oh, sure.
This is round, there's square,
we have window boxes.
That's cool because it goes on top of a railing.
It goes right on
right
the
on
railing
top.
And
beautiful.
Stays there.
Okay.
And if you want to cheat, Willey's actually does a
of course we do.
Completely
of course
done,
we do.
Absolutely
got it ready
beautiful
for you.
Combination.
Yeah.
So I settled on a yellow.
Okay.
I was thinking more in the Easter theme, which is going to be mid-April this year, so we've got time for it. I could have gone, I usually head for the turquoise when it's me.
And
that's
they're beautiful
my
colors, and there's purple, there's all kinds of different colors, but we went with the yellow today.
We did.
Okay.
So if I had gone turquoise, I would have gone with these beautiful corals and whites and yellows.
The accent of
just really
beautiful.
Would have been beautiful.
Very nice.
But we're
going
to do more of an Easter theme here with yellows and blues and purples.
All right.
Remember what we said last time, with a container, we always have a thriller, a filler, and spillers.
Spiller, okay.
So for a thriller, I picked this
pretty.
Lime cypress. I thought it was a really nice, fresh spring green and would pick up the color of the pot and just get us going on kind of a whimsical note because it is spring, so we want to be sprightly and happy and
Why
have a
not?
Good time.
Now, is that about the size that will get?
this won't get too much bigger.
Okay.
It's actually a tropical, so if you bring this in the house in the winter, mm-hmm. you could keep this forever, and it will continue to grow.
Okay.
You could grow this to a great big standard with a big puffy head if you wanted to.
All right, so we've got our...
Lemon cypress.
Lemon cypress, okay.
Okay, so that's our thriller. Then we'll go in with some color, and I went with the purples. This is a beautiful primrose. Mm-hmm. This one's called Sky Blue. Primrose is great early spring color. These plants have antifreeze in their system, so you can actually freeze these things solid
really?
And they'll come back.
Oh my
incredible.
Gosh. It's always so nice to see the beautiful primroses first thing in the spring because everybody is just ready for the color that
they're
they
bring. So cheery. And I buy them by the armfuls and put them around the house too. Because they're inexpensive, mm-hmm. long-lasting, it's great color, and they don't really intrude on your interior decorating, but they pick everybody up. It really gives you a good feeling. I like flowers in the house as
yes,
well as outside.
I do too.
So I'm going to fill in with these sky blues,
okay.
and then I'm going to continue with purple. Purple being the number one color. Flower color that sells.
I bet.
Believe it or not.
And I did want to this another couple options as far as color is concerned.
Oh, there's
with the
tons
primrose.
Of colors.
Yeah, beautiful, beautiful colors.
Yeah, I bet you've got half a dozen colors over there at
Absolutely.
Least.
Absolutely.
And
yeah.
usually more. This is a perennial. This is a juga. It's a ground cover. It's part of the Jeepers Creepers
out.
Program.
Okay.
Spreads out and gets this beautiful sky blue
the
pinnacle.
Flower. Now, is that only in the spring? Does it flower only in the spring?
And only then... in the spring.
Okay.
Most perennials have a bloom window.
Mm-hmm.
The reason we really like annuals is because they will bloom all
sure.
through the whole season.
Okay.
But we have to replace them. A perennial will last forever, or at least for a long time, but the flower comes and goes.
Okay.
So you have to plant a perennial garden around that.
Okay.
Not to say we shouldn't use it. It's absolutely beautiful. And look how the color coordinates
yeah,
with
it's
the,
nice.
The primrose.
That's nice.
And then you get your spiller with these plants coming over the side. And the ajuga can be taken out of the container when you're done and planted in the yard for a ground cover.
Good to know. Okay.
Does very well in sun or shade.
Now what else are we going to put in here?
We're going to put in some frizzle sizzle because we're staying whimsical. It is Easter.
The names are great.
This one's called Frizzle Sizzle
okay.
Burgundy, but it's really a nice purpley blue. And I think they coordinate well. Do you want to hold that?
I'll hold it.
This is the best way to do this. Just rip those little sides open and
it's got a
tear them apart.
A lot of nice root structure down there.
Absolutely beautiful.
Yeah.
The roots are nice and white. And something like this, you don't have to rip things apart.
Oh, okay.
You can just place them in the container and snug them down into the dirt. I'm just going to place it now and we'll go back and add.
Okay.
Add the potting soil to fill it in. So these are pretty inexpensive and you get a whole six pack, so be liberal with these. Pansy breeding is getting better and better. Pansies are lasting longer and longer into the season. So you should see good color on these frizzle sizzles until end of June.
Oh, that's
depending
nice.
On the weather.
Yeah, yeah. That's good.
Okay, that one hasn't really popped yet, so we'll put that one towards the black.
Put that one hide in the back.
Okay.
There we go.
And a little more frizzle sizzle here.
Okay, and one more.
All right, that's terrific.
Okay.
Now, to add to it, I'm going to put another ajuga in here just to balance things out. And this Jeepers Creepers program is a great program. You can depend on those ground covers lasting for a really long time
mm-hmm.
and not being invasive in your yard
okay.
so you're not giving yourself a problem.
Yeah, because that's really important. Some people look at one thing and they go, oh, that's beautiful, and they take it home, and all of a sudden in 3 years, it's everywhere.
It's true. It's true. And so we won't do that to you.
Okay.
Absolutely not.
All right, good.
And I just wanted to talk about some of the other options we could add. We've got these beautiful four-leaf clovers that come in different colors.
I've never seen one that color, actually.
Isn't that beautiful? That is brand new from Greenfuse. That's beautiful new breeding. This is not invasive, won't take over the yard.
Okay.
It is a very hardy perennial, though, so absolutely beautiful in the pots. And that'll give us a little pop of purple.
Okay.
Okay. Let's stick that in there.
Find a little hole for it.
That's exactly what you have
now,
to do at this
can
point.
Can you overcrowd your container?
Not really. You're going to put potting soil in there, and everything will meld together.
Okay.
Everything will fit. I like instant gratification. I like to plant my planter. And especially this time of year when it's cold, the plants are performing for you and giving you beautiful color, but they're not really going to grow until things warm up a little bit.
Okay.
So much better to crowd the color in there and get what you want.
So this is one that's going to last a little bit farther into the season.
This will last well into the season.
Okay.
And then when things do get warmer, then you go to your annual four pack. So this is a beautiful proven winner with a Bordeaux petunia, which will fit in very nicely.
So which would you take one of these out?
The primrose is going to say goodbye first.
Okay, the primrose is going to say bye-bye.
They're going to get tired.
Okay.
And luckily, the clover, the four-leaf clover here, is going to stay good all season, so that beautiful burgundy color.
And we're continuing with the same color theme.
We'll continue. The ajuga will still give you this beautiful variegated foliage, almost like a vinca vine.
Okay.
So I would leave that
there. I love vinca.
Isn't that nice?
I have vinca vine. I buy vinca for my beds, and then I have the ground cover also out there. I love it. I think
At the end of the season, you can pull this ajuga out and put it in your yard, and you'll have a beautiful variegated, this light variegation will really pick up shady areas.
Okay, cool. All right.
So
what else do we want to share today?
I just wanted to say you could incorporate beautiful vegetables.
So you could do a container with vegetables.
Look at the colors. Wouldn't that be pretty?
That's true.
That would be great. And then you could eat those lettuces. Just pick and choose. Also, herbs would be beautiful spillers. A golden oregano.
Basil. I love to have basil available
all
the time.
And the fragrance and the utility then just come out and pick a little bit for marinades and so forth. You can also use perennials.
We could do perennials here?
Yeah. There's a great selection
different kinds of shamrocks,
colors.
Dianthus.
Hellebores, which are terrific in the yard.
Okay. So suffice it to say, we've got a ton of options here to do your early spring planting, and all kinds of colors, not only in the flowers, but in the planters as well.
And don't forget that Willey's carries a huge selection already done for you.
There we go.
So you can
already
pop in 5 minutes later, your porch or your doorstep is gorgeous.
And we won't let anybody know that you didn't do it. Just pretend.
Yeah,
pretend. There you go. So, Heather, thank you so much for stopping by again and
it's
giving
us a pleasure.
All this really great information. So, go planting.
Bye.
Well, my thanks again to Heather for coming and showing us all this great information about our early spring flowers and planting. We talked a lot about flowers and silks and your garden today. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching today. Willey Farms, very easy to find on Route 13. If you're traveling on Route 1, just get off on 13 at Odessa, or if you're coming up from the south, get off North Smyrna and follow Route 13. We're very easy to find. You can also find us at www.willeyfarmsde.com. We're on Instagram, we're on Facebook. You can find us, I know that you can. Thanks for watching. You have a great day.